Welcome to a new video, and today I'm gonna talk about the 11th SS Freiwilligen Panzergrenadier Division Nordland. Officially sanctioned and sponsored by Himmler and the Waffen-SS, the Nordland Regiment of the 5th SS Panzergrenadier Division, Viking, was the most successful division of the Nordic units. Since it was not considered a national unit, the Nordland Regiment could more successfully recruit and replace combat losses. Like the Freikorps and Legion, the Nordland Regiment was initially composed of Danish and Norwegian volunteers, unlike its fellow Scandinavian formations. However, the regiment also included a battalion of 800 Finns that would stay with the unit until April 1943, when it returned home and was replaced by an Estonian battalion. The regiment also participated in Operation Barbarossa. Although not sent across the border until the second week of fighting, the men of the Nordland regiment performed well in the early action in the Galicia on their way to the Dnieper River. The autumn of 1941 found the regiment involved in heavy fighting near Rostov before being pulled from the line for a break. After entrenching on the Don River for the winter, the regiment searched across its banks toward the Caucasus oil fields as part of Operation Maus. The spring and summer of 1942 brought unexpectedly easy gains as the regiment helped to capture the southern Caucasus down at Caspian. Soviet resistance stiffened. However, as the regiment approached the terrain outside Grunsi, sent on an ill-planned mission to capture Hill 701, the fighting strength of Nordland was cut almost in half just in an hour. In spite of these horrendous losses, the regiment still managed to capture the hill and the enemy positions. Once word spread of the encirclement of Stalingrad of the German 6th Army, operation of the Caucasus slowed to a halting. Actions as focus was shifted northwards. As the predicament in Stalingrad became more serious, frontline units including the Viking Regiment were withdrawn through Rostov Gap in February 1943. Once through the gap, Viking was sent to the Kharkov in the Ukraine to protect vital rail lines and recapture the city. Despite being heavily outnumbered in infantry and armor, Nordland and his sister regiments managed to repel the attacks of the Soviet mobile group Popov. Once in Kharkov was recaptured, the Viking division was pulled off the front lines for refitting. The summer of 1943 saw the final steps towards consolidation of the three Scandinavian units into the Wehrmacht. The veterans of the SS Panzergrenadier Regiment Nordland was sent to Gravenwort training area in Bavaria to form the core of the new 11th SS Freiwilligen Panzergrenadier Division Nordland. At first, given the name Frangians after the Viking bodyguards of the Byzantine emperors, Hitler overruled Himmler and ordered the division to keep its regimental name, Nordland. While the division retained its old name, the two newly formed Panzergrenadier regiments received new names. SS Panzergrenadier Regiment 23 was made up Norwegian and Swedish volunteers and named Norge, while the SS Panzergrenadier Regiment 24 was comprised of Danish troops and named Denmark. As Nordland was fleshed out, not all of the volunteers were from Norway, Denmark or Sweden. Over 1200 Romanian Volksdeutsche, ethnic Germans from Romania, were added to strengthen the SS Panzergrenadier Regiment 24 Denmark alone. Now stationed into the Balkans, the Nordland division hunted Josef Tito's partisans through the northern Croatian in an effort to capture and kill the guerrilla forces. Once blooded into the Balkans, Nordland and the rest of the 3rd SS Panzer Corps were sent north to Leningrad in January 1944 to help contain the imminent Soviet breakout. Barely had the Nordland men dug in around the city before the communists exploded through beleaguered German siege forces. Not even the stalwart Scandinavians could stem the tide as the Nordland division was forced to fight a 20-mile rearguard action. This was followed a week later by a hurried withdrawal 65 miles farther west to the Baltic Sea port of Narva on the Estonian coast. Army Group Nord had set up a defensive position on the Narva River to halt the Russians' advance and reorganize for a counteroffensive. Known to some as the Battle of the European SS, the Battle of Narva saw some combatants of Germany, Norway, Denmark, Holland, Belgium and Estonia struggle to repel vengeful Soviets. Several river and lake crossing attempts were made by the attackers, only to be thwarted, most notably an amphibious landing force at the Merkul destroyed by Nordland forces in February 1944. A statement to the skill and tenacity of the SS men, and Nordland in particular, is that took 200,000 Soviets 5 months to displace the 50,000 defenders. Having retreated to the Tannenberg line, Nordland soldiers took up an already established position on the Oppahange Hill, 15 miles west of Narva, in July 1944. Here the division's luck began to run out. SS Gruppenführer Scholz and the commanders of both Panzergrenadier regiments were killed in combat on the 29th of July. In spite of these crushing losses, the Nordland troops preserved destroying over 100 Soviet tanks on that same day. Despite the staff defense of the Tannenberg line, a summer evacuation to Latvia was ordered for the division. Barely a month after arriving to defend the Latvian capital of Riga, the city fell to the Soviets and another evacuation was carried out. This time the division was sent to Kurland Pocket to buy time for the retreating German forces. Fall and early winter of 1944 found the division fighting numerous holding actions in Courland Pocket, as other German formations were sent by the sea to northern Germany. At last in January 1945, Nordland was withdrawn to Libau and shipped in Stettin in Pomerania. Now back in Germany, the division resupplied and received much needed replacements, including a small detachment of British SS soldiers in mid-February. These reinforcements helped strengthen the Nordland to launch a counterattack towards the Arnswalde to rescue an encirclement garrison and bring them back to the 3rd SS Panzer Corps lines on the Oder River. These positions couldn't be held. However, the Soviets launched a massive offensive on the 1st of March that would throw the corps into the eastern side of the Oder. These engagements depleted the combat strength of the Norge and Denmark regiments so much that the Nordland division was withdrawn from the line and sent to Bad Freienwalde for refit. More replacements and reinforcements joined the division before it was sent back to the line in mid-April. In less than a week, the division was pushed from the outskirts of Berlin to the city center. By the end of April, both Panzergrenadier regiments had ceased to exist as combat units and nothing larger than a company could be scraped together. Following Hitler's suicide, SS Brigadeführer Gustav Krukenberg, now Nordland's division commander, ordered his remaining troops to retreat towards the Elbe River in the relative safety of the Western Allies. While many survivors made it to the Elbe, most did not and fell into the hands of the Soviet conquerors. Thanks for watching this video. Please leave a like and subscribe if you did, and I hope to see you in the next video.